Hello. I'm getting organized, so we'll just wait for a few while I'm doing that and say hello if you're here. I did just realize I'm working with several printables and I probably should give you guys the names of the printable, the Etsy shops where I got the printables. So let me work on that really quick. Because I have some really cute ones here. Okay, so this one was Kay and May. I'm actually just going to get the shop name and not the exact listing because it's going to take me a while. Okay, so vintage tickets, and I'll show you what we're working with in a sec. Oh, wait. That works. Okay, so anyways, hello. I'm gonna go ahead and in the comments, I am going to put one of the shop names. I just wanna see if I copy and pasted the shop name the website, right? So if someone could do me a favor and click on that website and then just let me know, does it actually take you to the shop on Etsy? Just because I've done this before where I copy and pasted and for some reason it took you to like the login account. Like, I don't really know. It should be a simple thing, but I swear I've messed this up before. Okay, there's that one. And then what else we have? Really cute. Look how cute these are. They're like journaling cards. So I'm gonna put all of these links in the description in just a sec. Children's journal cards. Okay. And then what else? I feel like there's another one I'm working with. Oh, I didn't print that one out yet. I also got these really cute printable, hang on, that was like, hang on, let me just go to it. I forget what it was actually. It was vintage printable color toy catalogs, and I haven't printed that one yet, so maybe I will print one and I can show you. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with it yet, but I am basically, if yeah, you probably saw the title, I'm working on vintage children's like back to school themed journal embellishments. So I am using a lot of printables this time. Print this one out, but that's a full page. That's okay. We'll print that out. Okay. Okay, let me just copy and paste this one really quick. Vintage. What did they call that? My phone is being really annoying for some reason. Like, let me go back. You jackwagon? Toy catalog. Okay. Toy catalog. Paste. Okay. Then there's one more that I already bought. How are you guys, by the way? If you haven't answered, if you're just hopping on, I saw a few comments, so I'm going to catch up here in just a sec. Oh, here we go. Allie, I don't know how to say this, but I've ordered printables from them before. It's Allegra Digital. I can read, copy and paste. And these are also vintage kids' journal cards, we'll call it. Or alphabet. Alphabet. Okay. I just wanted to make sure that anyone who wants the Etsy shops for these lovely items can have them. So we will copy now and... Oh, can I not? I might not be able to edit the description right now for some reason. So I will just put it in the comments. Okay. Once I hop off of here, well, let me not put that many. Oh, come on, would ya? Saying I have two, all right. I might have to do these individually and then add it to the description later, but it's okay. There's the hello guys. I see a bunch of you saying hi. Let me just finish adding all of these links. There's a lot. I just know if I don't do it now, I might forget later. Okay, and one more. So, I guess I can't really pin all of these, but either way, you can scroll through the comments and get the links if you want. And then once I am all done with this live, I'll go back to, I'm trying to figure out if I can do it this way. I'll go back and put it in the description. Okay, I just want to get on with the fun crafting. So, I'm just going to try one more thing. Nah, I'm not even. Not even. Let's go to the live chat. It's easier for me to read here, but hi, Nancy. Oh, thank you for checking the link for me and Marianne and Joanne. Hello. Ooh, hello to Argentina. And hi, Katie. Just too. Hi, Ramona. How are you? I'm happy you could catch me live, too. I might be using some of the things I got from your shop. I'm not sure. I think I was possibly using some of the vintage papers that I got from your shop, Ramona. You sent me a bunch of vintage paper packs. Anyways, so like I said, I'm gonna cut out some of these tickets. And if you're just hopping on, I did put all of the shop links in the comments. I'm gonna cut out some of these tickets. But yes, I'm working on like finalizing my ideas for September's Patreon packs. And I do just wanna say quickly, thank you guys so much for your support on my channel. Lately, I feel like there's just been an abundance of support and I appreciate it. YouTube views are just down like crazy. And I even have a bunch of people messaging me saying like, hey, I just have a question. I don't know what's going on with my channel. I don't know if I am like doing something wrong, but my views are down. And it's just like that for everyone. Someone reminded me that YouTube is so, there's ebbs and flows, and this happens every year. People are on vacations, busy with their kids, not as much time to go on YouTube. So it is a normal thing in case you're also a YouTuber, but it definitely is kind of hard if this is kind of, if this is your job. So I just want to say thank you guys so much for your support. I've been doing a lot of extra things like de-stash sales, journal sales, which has been so challenging because I'm also getting over having a herniated disc. So my arm is affected. Today it's actually feeling pretty good. But also like I've been receiving like super chats. That's another way that you can support this channel. I never ever expect you guys to do those types of things. I've taken on a couple extra sponsored videos, which I don't usually do, not really any reason. I just don't really have a ton of time to make that a priority, but I'm working with some companies that I'm actually really excited about. So there's that. Another way is if you've ever been interested in being a Patreon member, that's another way that you can help support me here on this channel and also, you know, receive rewards that way. So you're putting money towards something that you're actually going to receive, like fun. I call them pen pal packs, but journal packs, Patreon packs, whatever. So you can check all of that out. I have all of those links, but I just really want to say thank you guys so much for all of your support. even if it's just watching me here. I appreciate. So I'm cutting these cute little tickets, and these were printable, obviously. And they're kind of like a vintage back to school theme, and I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do with the tickets. They are cute on their own, but I'm going to create something that can be used in journals. Ooh, these might be a cute, like, let's see, there's so many things you can do with tickets. You can make tabs, you can use a strip of them for like a belly band. One thing that I think I'll try, so we can do a little crafting together. Let's see. I do also want to possibly like collage on these flashcards, but I think something that would be cute. I went over some ideas with my friend Maddie, who's on the lives a lot, and she gave me an idea of decoupaging on envelopes using like, maybe I can use like vocabulary paper, or I'm not exactly sure, but I want it to look like back to school theme. So I think the first thing I'm gonna do is embellish some library cards, because I feel like those are very reminiscent, is that the right word? Reminiscent of elementary school, and that's kind of the timeline that I'm going for. So I think that's what we're gonna do. And we are just gonna stand here like this, so you might not see every little detail, but I'm gonna do my best at making sure that you guys can see, maybe you can see kind of what I'm doing there. And let me grab this vintage catalog advertisement that I just printed, because this might be fun to use for collaging. Yeah, that is really fun. So, you know, if you don't have access to many children's books or magazines like these, there are options on Etsy for printables. And I mean, I think they're just as fun to use. Let's see here. Oh, hi, Maddie. I didn't realize you were in here. And hello, Bobby. Thank you. Okay, so like I said, I think I'm going to start with this project where I'm going to basically embellish a library card. This is kind of how I come up with my Patreon ideas for the month. I just start getting ideas rolling in my head. Sometimes I do this months in advance and I'll write them down. But sometimes I'm doing it just like a week or two before I need to have my final ideas. It just really depends. But yeah, so I kind of just start out with ideas in my head, and then I start to play around and actually put them on paper, make them come to life. And then from there, I kind of finalize what my Patreon pack is going to consist of. There's different tiers, so I have to decide like who's getting what and all of that. So, okay, I'm gonna look through. I have some little vintage vocabulary cards. Could use these. I think I want, let me see what other vintage papers I have. This is, I really like, what do you call this paper again? It's not, graph paper, I guess. But I'm also trying to think of ledger paper. I love ledger paper so much. But I think for this one, I'm going to start by, I think I'm just going to layer on some different papers to start with. I'm running out of glue also. I probably need to go to Michael, or probably not Michael. I don't know, actually. No, I hate buying glue from Michael's, actually. Shouldn't have waited till last minute. Okay. So I'm probably just gonna glue on some layers, maybe some lace. I have lots of vintage lace right now, so much. And I wanna give you a sneak peek of almost my finalized French document journal. Not quite, because I haven't glued on the cover pieces, but it's gonna look a little something like this. And this one right here is like a little pocket that has a little tag. I don't have these glued on right now, so gotta take those off. And this is filled with all of the lace in here is vintage, and I don't have it sewn shut yet, but I'll just give you a little sneak peek here. So wallpapers, lots of embellishments, lots of pretty, there's French papers in here, like book pages and magazines, magazine pages. Every page has either lace or a lace tab, a little bit of write, not a little bit, there's a lot, but right, you know, writing space. I'm not completely done with this either. Coffee dyed paper, full pockets. I'm hoping to make some of these up this weekend. Not hoping, I'm going to, I just don't know how much I'm gonna make. There's like full side pockets, lace pockets, top loading pockets, glassine bags, all of that. So I'm really excited to finish this and get the darn journal completed. And I am filming a video where we're going to make French document journal embellishments. Whoa, it's 103 there, Maddie. That's crazy. It's 93 here and a little smoky, but yeah. Okay, so anyways, that's just me sidetracking. After this project today, I'm going to be working on the French document journals and I'm very excited. Okay, so we have some papers layered here. Oh yeah, let's do lace next. And I will be using the vintage laces. Let's see, I'll be holding this up. I'm thinking, it's hard to know. So I love these colored tickets. They also seem to go with the theme really great. They're just little clothing tickets, but I just think the bright colors really go along with it. I'm not sure if I should make little snippets with these on their own, and then they could be really cute used in your journals, like as a tab, or even just like to top an envelope flap or whatever. Or I could use them on these, which that could be cute, but let's see how we like the journaling cards layered on. I think that might make these a really nice like centerpiece. Let's just use one of those. Actually, I'm gonna use this one. It says read, and it has some writing paper on it. Lined paper, I should say. I was gonna try to cut all these out before I came on here, but then I got anxious. Ooh, you're saying it's bad in Wisconsin. It's worse on concrete, yes, humidity. You know, one night I got wrapped into watching videos to see if it was possible to fry an egg on hot concrete. And I thought you probably could if it was like 112 out, but no one could do it. It has to be hotter than that. I don't know, random. I literally spent time doing that. Okay. Maybe let's use a little piece of, maybe some book page. That could look cute. I have this vintage children's book, although I don't really want to use up the illustrations for this part. So we'll just layer on. In fact, maybe I'm gonna tear a little bit of this so it's a little smaller. And I like the ripped edges on these kinds of things. Yeah, okay. I think I'm liking this. I'm thinking that staples are gonna look good on a project like this because I also feel like staples are, I don't know, they go with the whole school theme. We'll do three. And then our lace will be attached. I don't have to worry too much about that. Yes, cute. Okay, I'm gonna lift this up and show you guys in just a sec. you can give me some ideas if I should add anything to finish it off. I want you to see the papers, all the papers that I layered. These are gonna be so cute. And perhaps I could take one of these tickets. Okay, well, let me show you the pocket first. And I just ordered a bunch of library pockets and cards, so I have white ones coming. I like the yellow too. This is what I've got. So we have some book page, some lace, some graph paper in the back. I can tell that it's not super clear, so I hope you can see that okay. And then why don't we also, I was thinking I could do something to the card inside, and I kind of like the idea of I could maybe add a little ticket. Could do that, like that. It could go inside or outside, and maybe I can staple at the top. Let's see what you guys think. Oh, hi, Amy. Well, welcome. I'm glad that you have made it to your first live. We had a teacher here put crayons glued to the foam board to see if they would melt and run, and they did. That's funny. Hello, never enough time. How are you? Okay, I'm working on some little vintage library cards that are embellished. And I think I'm just gonna go ahead and staple on. Actually, maybe I will do some layering here. We'll make a like, and these are just ideas right now. So although this theme will definitely be used in September's Patreon, just in case you're a member or looking to be a member, this month is going to be really fun, or September, I should say, but these probably aren't the final ideas. I'm going to figure out what I like best. So just keep that in mind. Actually, yeah, maybe I'm gonna staple like that. Yeah, and then maybe keep the card blank so that you would have space for journaling or adding a picture or something like that. Because I'm always looking for ways in my own personal journal to have cute decorations like this, but I put a lot of pictures and personal journaling in my journals, but I don't always want those to be like the main, what's the word I'm looking for? I don't want them to be like the main image on my journal spreads. I want them to be cute and decorated. And so I'm always looking for something like this where I can have this cute decorated little piece in my journal, but then in here I'll actually have personal journaling, and maybe on the back I have a picture of my kids. And then I can tuck it away and it's still this cute little centerpiece in my journal. You know what I mean? And sometimes I do use personal pictures as like the main image, but a lot of times this is what I prefer. So that's what I tend to do when I am journaling. Okay, so yeah, let me know your thoughts on this. I think I like it. I'm probably gonna have to play around with a few different ways to make these, but I am always keeping in mind too, if this is going to be my main item for Patreon, I need to make 120 of these. So I want it to be something like a main piece that you can use in your journal, but I also have to keep in mind, like, do I need to cut out 120 tickets? You know what I mean? So anyways, I think I'm gonna keep this and we'll just move on to another little, maybe we'll make some snippets with these tags. Or I also have index cards, which could be fun. Where did I see? I had an idea and I set it aside. Maddie, you'll have to tell me if you were the one who made this. It might have been Ramona or someone else. I mean, I've used collage cards, or sorry, I've used index cards quite a bit. But this one, I really, really liked it. I liked how there's something in this corner and this corner. So I was thinking I could do something like that. I thought you did. Well, I love it. And so I put it on my little cart here for inspiration this month. I need to get some lined index cards because mine are blank. I don't know how I bought those, and I'm probably going to go to the Dollar Tree today to see what all I can find. But anyway, so love that. And so I'm just going to keep that out as an idea. Maddie, also, if you guys are interested, just because you can put your link, your shop link, Maddie, because I didn't do that, but she has these colored tags, and I am actually glad she does, because on Amazon you can buy these, but you have to buy a pack of like 2,000, I think it was. And even for me, I go through things in bulk pretty quick, but I didn't want 2,000 of these, so got these from her shop, and so I'm glad for that. So thank you for sending those over. Okay, also I'm really digging this vintage catalog. Like, this reminds me so much of my childhood, going through those catalogs and circling all the toys I wanted. So let's see, maybe I can decorate an envelope, and then we'll also do a snippet. Yeah, let's do that. I need to give myself enough time today to work on my French document journals, and I'm also going to make some of the journal toppers separate. And I did a journal topper pocket, just so you know. So yeah, so I have lots of things I got to do today. Okay. So let's see here. Let's go ahead and I printed this on thick paper, and if I'm actually going to use it as like a decoupage thing, I would probably print it on just printer paper, but that's okay. I think I'm just going to cut the edges off real quick. And then let me use a ruler. I'm trying to just think of what I want to do here. Always a bit messy when I am gathering my ideas for Patreon. Okay, I'm just using my ruler to take this down a bit. Darn, my finger, if you didn't know, has been numb, and it's actually not numb, it's tingly, which is annoying, but I'm kind of hopeful that that means something good. I feel like it might. And I'm in a lot less pain also, so I'm like feeling very excited. So I need to be able to use my hands. Okay. What I don't have a lot of is, I wanted to find some vintage children's like vocabulary paper. I'm not sure what you call it. I think I might be able to get some at the Dollar Tree. It won't be vintage, but it'll be just fine for collaging with, you know. And so if I do something with the envelopes, this is probably something that I would add into my Orchid tier members, because I always leave one of the items that's kind of like a bigger item that goes to only my Orchid members. And so it would probably be something like this if I end up. And I'm just letting you know, in case maybe you're someone who's wanting to sign up, or if you are a Patreon member and you've been wanting to upgrade, I should have looked. I should have spots available on Patreon, and if I don't, I can add at least a few, because I have been having a little bit of leftover packs every month. And my kids are going back to school next month, which I'm sad about, but I'm always excited to be able to work, honestly. Let's see. Yes, Madeline always does send extras for Paper Terrace viewers. Oh, good. Okay, you guys are chatting. Packs of 250 index cards for back to school. Great. Yeah, I think I'm going to try to go there today. And if I do, I can also film a little shopping video. Okay. I'm just going to start collaging on some papers on the envelope here. I don't really know what I'm doing here, but I don't know how this is going to end up. Let's see. I think for this, I'm not going to add any fabric or lace. It's going to be more of a flat, just paper. So maybe I should do some stamping. Let's see. What kind of stamping do we want? I looked online today for maybe some vintage, or what am I trying to say? Some stamps that would kind of go with this theme. Ooh, actually, you know what? What if, let me grab my stamp thing here. It might look kind of cool just to stamp like ABC with these Tim Holtz stickers. I feel like that will actually maybe work. Let's just try it. ABCD, maybe, just some of the letters. It wouldn't even have to be ABCD, but I think that will look good. So let me, I'm gonna kind of put them messily in order here. And I love being able to use things that I already have. But I am gonna use black ink for this because I do kind of want it to stand out. And also I have to touch the screen for these comments to come up. So if you ask me a question or something and I don't see it, I will get to it, darn it. I gotta use like a glue stick to make these stamps fit or stick. Now that they have way more than enough ink than they need. Alright, we're just gonna get this ink out of the way so that I don't accidentally stamp everything. I'm just gonna stamp this up in the corner. Oh, that might be a little too dark, but that's okay. I'll show you guys in a sec here. I'm not sure what I'm going to do to the back yet, so maybe I shouldn't have done that, but okay. I'm going to ink up the edges. I know it still needs something, and I'm not sure what, but I'm going to show you guys and let me know if you have any ideas. I could use, so this is what we got. Next time, I probably will use brown ink for the ABCD kind of thing, and I don't know if I'll use it. I like the catalog stuff here, but I feel like I want more of a focal point like image. So I'm not sure. I have lots of printables and things that I could use. We have more of these like flashcards, or I have tickets. There's ink all over me. Let's see what you guys think. Joanne, I'm addicted to Dollar Tree. I know, right? So let's see. I'm just gonna play around and like put different things on here. I do really like these little tags on here, but I also kind of wanted to save these for little snippets. So let's see. I don't have many of these, but I do have some vintage children's like alphabet, or I don't know what kind of book it was. Let's see here. Where is my ruler? Right there. The only thing is, to do this, I would need a lot of these images, and I'm not sure I will be able to get my hands on too many children's books for images right now. I have been looking. I've actually been looking on eBay and Etsy, but they are really hard to find. So I don't know if this would be too much. And again, I don't even know that I can make this work because I don't have a ton, but that is really cute. I don't know if it's too much though. I mean, maybe I should just keep the catalog paper, but then add, it's missing something. What do you guys think? Give me your feedback. If you're one of my Patreon members, let me know. Let's see, I always find bonus packs of school supplies at Dollar Tree this time of year. Yeah, Cool. I'm really excited to go to the Dollar Tree today. Okay, so yeah. Anyway, so I'm going to maybe go over to the snippet, but let me know what you think. I mean, I also got ink all over the back of this, but I probably won't do too much to the back. I'm mainly going to be focused on the front. So I like it, but it's missing something. Okay, so snippets. I think this will be really cute. Ooh, sorry. I am looking. I don't have a ton of these either, but I could also do maybe like vocabulary cards. I don't know. I feel like it's maybe taking away from it. Maybe I should just keep it and maybe add like some kind of little sticker. Ooh, tickets. But different kinds of tickets. These I got from Ramona's shop. That might be cute. I can't tell. I have these a bunch of these tickets, so I could just add something like that in the corner. I think I like that, but okay, I'm still gonna hold off, see what you guys say, and let's work on our little snippets. And these are going to be simple. I'm gonna just have some layered paper, so I'm gonna use some graph paper. I want some of the writing to show through, so you know it's a little like clothing tag. Let's see, I think I will use lace on these ones. I have so much lace right now, which is exciting. Ooh, actually, I also have a ton of vintage, ooh yes, I think I have enough for everyone to have this on theirs, but rickrack, and I think that will be awesome to use on these. So we're opening her up. Gonna save the paper because I will use that. Let's see. Love your hair, Jessica. Thank you. I dyed it red a couple days ago. Hi, Kay. Yes, rickrack is adorable. And I could actually probably, depending on how much I have. One of my pen pal friends, Jade, just sent me a ton of vintage buttons and this kind of thing. So if I had enough, maybe this would be cute. Ooh, maybe this is what is missing on those envelopes. Even though I was thinking I'm just only going to add paper. I kind of like how that's looking. So when I like something, I just go for it. If I like it, I'll just grab it in a different color. If I like it and they have another color, consider it bought. Anywho, okay. I'm just gonna glue this rickrack on, but I also don't know how much I have, like I said. So I do also have vintage seam binding, which would look cute. Not as cute though. Pretty darn cute. I'll show ya. I like that a lot. I mean, and it's funny because it's like the smallest little thing, the smallest little touch. And unfortunately, my camera, for whatever reason, doesn't focus very good on smaller things, but yay, you like it. Thank you. Yes, I love it. Okay, cute. Well, this is pretty thin also, so maybe it would look better to have a thicker trim on these tickets anyways, but I'm just going to play around. Let's see. I'm going to grab some of the seam binding that I have. I think it's over here, so let me go grab that. And I mean, I guess lace might even work. Shoot, I don't know. Play around with it. Play around with it. Here we go. Oh, this is bias tape. Huh. Well, you know what? I'll show you bias. Okay. I'm actually going to use a little piece of lace, I think. I'll just do lace. Maybe a little piece of rickrack. And again, I'm going to lift this up and show you what I'm working with in just a moment. Maybe vintage book page. I just want to make sure you guys aren't like shouting out ideas. I swear I had a book page that I ripped already. Okay. Yeah, I've been excited for this month's theme since I got the idea last month, and I love when I'm super excited about something. Okay. There we go. This isn't book page, but it's gonna look like it. Yeah, I just want these to be kind of like little scrappy snippets. I don't know. Just like they are. Okay, I think we're gonna staple these. I like the look of a staple. Running out of staples. If I had colored staples, that would be so cute, but my colored staples don't fit in my tiny attacher. So odd. I had another little tiny attacher and I don't know where it is. Maybe I got rid of it or sold it. Because I do love my Tim Holtz tiny attacher very much. Okay. Yeah, these are pretty darn cute. I mean, they are simple, but I think they would look really cute on the edge of a page as a tab. Oh, what about dictionary pages? That is a great idea. I don't know. Oh wait, I have. Yeah, that's a good idea. Oh, I was gonna say, I don't know if I have a dictionary, but let me just show you. Yes, sir, I do. And it's huge, and I do use it all the time. But I'm gonna set her down for now. But if I make more of these, maybe I will use dictionary pages. That would be cute. But anyways, this is just, it's, I don't know what's on my finger, but this is what it looks like. And depending on which tier is getting it, I could also add some little, what am I trying to think? A little tie at the top. Let me find some twine. Where did you go? Where did you go? Sorry, I'm coming through. So I guess I could make these a tag or a snippet. Oh geez. We have a walnut tree in our backyard and so many walnuts are falling now. I kind of do like it as a tag actually. Especially with some fun little fiber. So yeah, that's really fun. I could add more of a focal point on these too. Wasn't that the biggest dictionary? Yeah, I could add a focal point. I'm going to see what I find at the Dollar Tree because Madeline, you were giving me an idea earlier if I found like little apple stickers, I think you said, or apple themed things. In fact, I have a ticket here that has an apple. I'm just going to try to cut that out. Obviously, I would not spend the time on cutting 100 of these out, but if I could find stickers, that would go with the theme very well. So I am just going to try it out here and see what we think about the apple. The apple. Man, last night there were thunderstorms and lightning and lots of rain, but there was like a couple times when I literally thought my tree, my walnut tree that's right next to my window was gonna come crashing down on me. I was worried for my life. Give me all your numbers so I can phone ya. Okay. Let's see. I think I'm just gonna glue her on. That could look darn cute. Will I find Apple stickers? We don't know. Definitely will be cute if you're actually doing like a back to school theme or vintage children's. It could really go so many ways. You could use it for a lot of different themes, even just vintage. Yeah, kids, I don't know. Love it, love it, love it. You know, in fact, I'm gonna go ahead, snap a little photo and say, yo, you're missing out, people. This camera is no good. Okay. And then, if you guys go on my Instagram later and you see this, you can say, I was there when you posted that picture. I dare you. I dare you. Don't miss out. Kiss, don't kiss out. Don't miss out on this fun vintage children's embellishing. And I'll say either watch the live or replay. Okay. And share. Okay, so yeah, I love how these are going. Feel free, let me know if you have any feedback. This would be a cute little pack. Again, I'm gonna finalize the ideas, but I think this is kind of how I decide on exactly what I'm going to put in the Patreon packs. I'll make up like a whole pack and I'm like, is this a whole pack? Like, could I do a really fun layout with this? Or does this feel complete? Like I could use this in, if I was working on like a smaller journal, could I use this to embellish the journal and kind of get that look or that vibe? Obviously one pack might not be enough to decorate a complete journal, but you do get, as an Orchid member, you also get a 10 piece junk journal kit, which is very basic things like guest checks, tags, basic things. So those are also things, you know, you can use in your journals, but yeah, I like it. Okay, bye. Thanks for hanging out, Maddie. So yeah, I'm trying to think. I definitely had some more ideas, but I feel like I think this is a good starting place. So I'm probably going to stop here because I also want to work on these French document journals so that I can make those available for you guys. Hopefully sometime next week, I'm guessing, but that's it. So I'm gonna go because I have lots to do today, but it was really fun hanging out. And if you just hopped on, just wait a few minutes and you can watch the replay. I gotta get to the Dollar Tree today so that I can finish getting a few supplies that I need for this stuff. And yeah, that's about it, guys. I do hope that you guys have a lovely rest of your day. I gotta clean up this mess. Go. Okay, so many little pieces of paper on my floor. I hate it. There we go. Okay, guys, have a good day. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.